The topic I want to talk about today is expected value and how it applies to investing. Now, the definition of expected value is the average results of an activity if it's done an unlimited number of times. And then if you have a number of activities that you want to choose between, you choose the one with the highest expected value. And if you do that throughout your life and whatever endeavor you're pursuing, you'll end up better off. Now, it sounds logical, but it's not as straightforward as that. So let me use an example. If I were to flip a coin and give you $100 if it came up heads and zero if it came up tails, the expected value of that coin flip would be $50, because if you did it an unlimited number of times, half the time it would be zero, half the time it would be 100, and so the average is 50. Now, if your alternative was I was just gonna give you 40 bucks, a lot of people would just take the $40 because it's cash in hand. But if you're using the expected value concept, you wanna take the coin flip because the expected value is higher than the 40 bucks. And if throughout your whole lifetime you're always making decisions that way, you'll have some that don't turn out because you could get the zero. But if you do it often enough, it will work out where you'll have likely better results over time. The way that applies to investing, there's a good example recently, as a matter of fact. Small company stocks have underperformed large company stocks for the last 5 years or so. But if you take 15-year rolling averages from 1927 to 2014, small cap beats large 82% of the time. So from an expected value standpoint, you want the small cap, but a lot of people these days are shifting to large because recently it's just done better. Now, keep in mind, this has to do with an overall asset allocation model. I'm not telling you to put all your money into small cap, but when you are making adjustments, don't do it just because of recent results. It doesn't make a lot of sense logically. All right, hopefully that's a tool you can use to keep yourself more disciplined when you make your own investment decisions. If you have other questions, you can go to purefinancial.com.